Good morning, everybody. We're certainly happy to be joined by our mayor, the Honorable LaToya Cantrell, and I'm joined by my deputy chiefs of the New Orleans Police Department and our partners with Louisiana State Police, the ATF, and the U.S. Marshals. We know that the summer months are often some of the most violent here in New Orleans. That's why, with the support of Mayor Cantrell, we heard your complaints, we heard your concerns, we heard it from non-PAC meetings, we heard it from community meetings, we heard your complaints through anonymous tips, and we did something about it. Yes, we did. Along with our law enforcement partners, many of them here today, more boots on the ground offering intelligence and tools that we need to prevent and to fight crime. This summer was no different. In fact, our summer crime suppression strategy was once again a huge success. That includes one of the largest undercover narcotics operations in recent years that started in early May, and as of today, we've arrested 71 drug dealers. And we have outstanding arrest warrants for an additional 54 drug dealers who we are coming for. That's a total of 125 drug cases. And so, assisted by the U.S. Marshal Service, our undercover officers came into contact with dozens of the most dangerous drug dealers in the city of New Orleans, selling everything from crack cocaine to heroin. We know that street-level drug dealing is a major concern for our citizens, as it is for our department. That's why our officers identified strategic locations across the city that were prone to violence, that were prone to drug dealing, along with locations that you told us about. As a young police officer, I actually did this work myself, working undercover. So I know how dangerous it can be. I know how intense it is to do this work, and I know what our teams went through to make this operation the success that it was. In addition to the roundup, our partners with the Louisiana State Police once again were gracious enough to deploy an additional 10 state troopers for the second year in a row to work closely with our officers in different parts of the city, and the results speak for themselves. In less than 2 months' time, the operation, which started on June 20th and runs through the end of this month, has already netted 110 arrests, 180 citations issued, which produce 27 illegal firearms, 18 stolen vehicles, and approximately $37,000 worth of illegal drugs. They assisted our officers with various things over 150 times while answering about 80 calls for service in support of our officers. We had a traffic enforcement that started early May, which yielded 4,500 citations, 290 DWI arrests with 100 misdemeanor arrests and 3 felony arrests. Those efforts also could not have been possible without another one of our partners, the ATF. They have been with us to offer around-the-clock support and with us on the ground in real time to evaluate whether these individuals should face prosecution in the federal system and then including face federal penalties for illegal guns and drug charges. Interagency cooperation is and always will be vital in carrying out these types of operations. And I would like to personally thank all of our partners with the State Police, the ATF, and the U.S. Marshals for their partnership in our summertime suppression efforts. Lastly, before I turn it over to the mayor, I want to present to you our major crime numbers for the first 6 months of this year, January through June 31st. Murders are down nearly 5%. Non-fatal shootings are down almost 38%. The number of people wounded in those shootings was down about 38%. That's more than 100 fewer victims of gun violence than during the same period in 2017. Armed robberies were down almost 15%. Burglaries were down 19%. And those numbers are continuing to trend down as we enter mid-August, with 76 fewer shootings compared to the same time last year and 120 fewer gunshot victims. Simply put, our strategic efforts of working together make us a better and a safer city. But we are never satisfied. We will continue to push forward and remove these bad actors from the streets who have proven to have no respect for the law and no regard for the lives of our citizens. So thank you. In a moment, we'll take a few questions, but I want to turn it over to the mayor to make remarks. Thank you, Mayor.
Thank you. And good morning again, and thank you for being here. More importantly, thank you, Chief.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you to our partners who are with us, State Police, ATF, U.S. Marshals. We have said that at the beginning of the Cantrell administration that public safety not only is a top priority, but we will address it and be laser focused on ensuring that our public, that our people are safe. And so this is a demonstration, a real example of that. We know that rounding up as it relates to drug trafficking, drug crimes, they're almost always aligned to other crimes that are committed on the streets of the city of New Orleans. One murder is too many, but you know what? We do have to showcase as it relates to progress that we are making on the streets of the city of New Orleans. And it's through these partnerships that will not end. We will continue to ensure that we move forward with them, we nurture them. But at the end of the day, we have to ensure that our officers on the ground have the tools and resources that they need to be effective, making thus the city of New Orleans safer. And we're doing that. Our officers, our detectives, investigators have been working tirelessly to round up and to show you what we've been able to do just today, leading up. 71 arrested, more to come, over 53. That we are not going to let up until we ensure that they are off the streets of New Orleans. And that's what this is all about, public safety for all of our residents. And again, thank you to all of our partners here. We cannot do it without you, but I want you to know that as your mayor, that I'm side by side. And as long as we're doing the right thing, and we are, then this administration will continue to push forward on public safety initiatives that we know will bring real results on the ground. So thank you.
Thank you for your leadership, Mayor. This time we'll take any questions you may have.
Quick question, Chief. Could you describe the operation for us? It looks like it was undercover, drug buys with warrants and a roundup later, is that correct?
That was one component of it, where undercover officers, based on tips that came in either anonymously or through other sources, community meetings and non-PAC meetings, we took those citizen complaints and then we went to the neighborhoods where we knew those drug dealings were occurring, and we engaged those drug dealers face to face and purchased contraband from them. So these cases are actually cases of distribution of contraband of different types to an undercover officer.
Kind of elaborate on the size of the drugs, the amount of drugs and types of drugs that...
It was various types of contraband, crack cocaine, marijuana, heroin. There may be others, but these were 125 total cases. So we've been able to round up 71, and we're coming for the other 54 that are out there. So if anyone has any information about them, their pictures are being given to you as we speak right now. Please call us to tell us where they are. You can call Crime Stoppers, but our investigators, detectives, and tactical officers will be on the ground pursuing them, looking to arrest them and hold them accountable for their actions. That roundup started last Monday, and so this is all in 1 week. And so those 71 were arrested during last week.
Up until today.
Yes.
Oftentimes these kind of operations hit the street level or the retail level of the drug trade. Are you doing anything to climb the ladder and break up some of the mid-level and upper-level dealers or the people behind?
We're always working on that, Mike. We're always working on that. But this is a result of the citizens' actual complaints that come directly to us. And this is our due diligence to deliver on a promise that we heard their concerns and we were doing something about it.
Chief, do you know if a lot of these individuals are repeat offenders? I was looking at some of the names earlier, some that we've already reported on just last year who were arrested for drugs and were obviously back out on the street.
A percentage of them will be repeat offenders. Some of them have histories of violence, but we were going after the complaints that came to us. And so this was our message to the citizens. Although you can't talk about it while it's underway, we wanted to make sure we delivered on a promise that we would go after the drug dealers on the corners, in the dark alleys, that are causing the neighborhoods to have complaints and causing concerns for the citizens.
Do we have any new information on the mass shooting, the 10 people wounded, or a suspect?
On the Claiborne Street murder, it is progressing. We are still following leads. Information has come in, but certainly if anyone has more, please continue to give that to us. Our investigators are still combing through evidence and following up on every single lead that comes in. I can tell you that they have not stopped. They've been working diligently, and it is progressing.
Chief, anything new in the case involving the burned bodies in Algiers?
That has some information that's coming in. There are leads that we are pursuing as well on that. And so as much information as we can get from the citizens will be helpful. Please continue to tell us what you know. But every single lead that's coming in, I can guarantee that our detectives are following every single lead. Right?
Couple more questions? This is a little off topic. I understand you can't answer it. Are we able to talk, Mayor Cantrell, at all about the residency clause within the Department of Public Works, Sewage and Water Board? Is that something we're looking to at all adjust following with people living not in Orleans Parish to work for the Sewage and Water Board?
What's your question? I mean, what is exactly your question? It's not relative to this effort this morning, is it? You're talking Sewage and Water Board, but we're here talking about public safety and how, through our partnerships, we have addressed issues that our residents are facing or have faced on a daily basis that lead to not just drug crime, but we know that it's aligned with other criminal activity that is hampering and burden our people. So that's what we're here to talk about this morning. We have real evidence and examples of how we're moving the needle. Our detectives are working tirelessly, not giving up. We're taking it very seriously. And we are getting results on the ground. That's what this is about. And we will not waver. We're very serious about this. And so as it relates to the last question you asked about Claiborne Avenue, I believe, and as you were told by the chief, we're not giving up. We're making great ground, but we're not going to jeopardize the investigation that's happening now, but it will be productive. So thank you, and I'll talk to you about Sewage and Water Board at another time.
How can people report anonymously?
They can call Crime Stoppers at 822-1111, and they can report those crimes that they witness, whether they're drug crimes or violent crimes. They can call Crime Stoppers and do that anonymously.
Chief, the other arrest that you were talking about, or a number of other things, DWI, was that throughout the summer?
That was throughout the summer, and so throughout the summer, there was a traffic enforcement with our traffic unit. There was a high visibility patrol with NOPD and state police partnerships with ATF on the ground with us. And that went on through every part of the city while this covert was going on in every part of the city. And it produced what you heard me say with the DWI arrest, the other misdemeanor felony arrest, illegal guns recovered, drugs recovered, stolen vehicles recovered. And so we feel that the men and women executed a plan to the T that's produced great results. We want to keep that going. It's making us a better and a safer city. We couldn't be more proud of the men and women that went out and executed this summer.
And we can get you those timelines. So is there any other questions?
One quick question. I noticed that shooting incidents and shooting victims are down, but assaults are up over the six-month period. Explain that.
The assaults make up the attempts of battery. So it could be somebody who fired a weapon, who swung a bat, who swung a knife, but missed. And so it is, an assault is really an attempted battery. And so fights, attempts, other crimes like that fall in the assault category. And it's usually, by and large, folks who know one another. We separated it out for you so you can see the actual shootings where victims were actually shot and the shooting incidents from the attempts of shootings or the attempts of batteries. All right. Thank you all so much.
Thank you.